Scuffles erupted outside a court in Beijing on Monday as a trial began for a prominent human rights lawyer. Pu Zhiqiang is accused of, quote, picking quarrels and inciting ethnic hatred. Now, the indictment cites several comments that Pu made on social media criticizing Chinese officials and policy. Now, the U.S. is urging China to release Pu, describing the charges against him as vague. The American Embassy in Beijing has issued this statement saying this, quote, lawyers and civil society leaders such as Mr. Pu should not be subject to continuing repression, but should be allowed to contribute to the building of a prosperous and stable China. The indictment, it cites seven comments that Pu allegedly made on Weibo, China's Twitter-like site, comments made between 2011 and 2014. Now, some of them mocked Communist Party officials and a pro-government author. Others are critical of Chinese policy in ethnically divided Tibet and Xinjiang. As seen as David McKenzie spoke to Pu in 2013, that was one full year before he was arrested. And back then, he seemed to feel immune from the reach of prosecutors.
I think I am fine. I am a moderate. The government has treated me well, and I am a veteran lawyer.
Pu is not the first human rights lawyer to be detained and put on trial in China. Earlier, I spoke to Roseanne Reif. She is the East Asia Research Director for Amnesty International. And I asked her why China is rounding up lawyers.
They've been successful at raising the cases and garnering attention, and I think the Chinese public is also becoming much more engaged in this debate, and I think that's worrying to the authorities. And so they want to shut down this very eloquent group of people who are out there defending rights.
Now, searches for Pu's name have been blocked on Weibo, but on the popular messaging app WeChat, some users have changed their profile pictures to an image of Pu to support him. I asked Roseanne Reif why there has been such an outpouring of support for Pu inside China, despite the risk.
It's home. They see that this is just speech, and as his lawyers have pointed out, that there was really no harm to any individuals. He was simply critiquing government policy and government officials, and they do this themselves. The Chinese social media is full of great sort of sarcastic comments and critiques of politicians all the time, and so this resonates with them.
And that was Roseanne Reif from Amnesty International speaking to me earlier. Now, one of Pu's most prominent clients, the Chinese dissident artist Ai Weiwei, has also taken to social media. He tweeted this, quote, when a duty becomes a crime, it's time to change the law.